Hey everyone, this is Aditi and you're watching Legal Bites. Our today's topic of discussion is pigeonhole theory. In this video, I'll be looking at the introduction to pigeonhole theory, meaning of pigeonhole theory, Winfield's theory of law of torts, then Salmond's theory of law of torts, followed by their supporters and the criticism of these theories. Now let's start our video. Coming to our first topic, that is introduction to pigeonhole theory. Pigeonhole theory is propounded by Sir John William Salmond. In this theory, he stated that in order to list any wrong as tort, they must have proper justification and definition which can be relatable to the other torts which is already confined in small boxes called pigeonhole. And every pigeonhole has different characteristics. He further stated that if a person can put any wrong committed to him in any of the pigeonhole, then only he will be entitled to damages. Now coming to the meaning of pigeonhole theory. Salmond in his theory stated that the liability under this branch of law arises only when the wrong is covered by anyone or the other nominated torts. And not only this, he also compared law of torts with criminal law and stated that just as the criminal law consists of a body of rules establishing specific offenses, so the law of torts consists of a body of rules establishing specific injuries. Winfield and Salmond theories are not in a major conflict within each other, rather they are the faces of the same coin. Now coming to the Winfield theory. According to Winfield, law of tort is a general liability which originates from the violation of duty which is determined by law. In other words, he means that for every wrongful act for which there is no valid justification, the person is held liable for committing law of tort. In this kind of interpretation, there is no need for a specific kind of tort to be committed, and only wrongful act which causes legal injury would be enough to satisfy the theory of law of tort. And not only this, but law of tort is an evolving concept, as when new torts are identified, they are then incorporated into law of tort. Winfield's idea of law of tort has a relevant case law, Ashby versus White. It is the foundational case law of English tort law, in which Mr. Ashby, the plaintiff who was stopped from voting an election by the defendant Mr. White. This case is concerned with a person's legal right infringement. The judgment in this case led to the formation of a new principle, that is injuria sine danno, and it states that if a person's legal right is violated, then he does not have to prove any damages. In short, it means only legal injury is prerequisite to invoke this principle. Now coming to Salmond's theory of law of torts. In this kind of theory, not only wrongful act must occur, but that act must originate from a specific tort. According to the interpretation of Sir Salmond, it is important for the wrongs to be concise and have the body of rules establishing specific principles like a criminal law system which is codified and have specific names of various offenses. According to this theory, the burden of proof is always on the plaintiff to prove that the act of the defendant falls in the bracket of specific wrongs. He further noted that the remedy would be available for any wrong that comes under the well-constructed notion of torts. Salmond's theory of law of torts has a relevant case law, Bollinger versus Castabre Wine Company Limited. This case was related to trademark infringement right, in which the judges of the case stated that Before a person makes claim for damages in law of torts, he she must prove that the act comes within the well-defined notion of torts. This judgment marks the evolution of Sir Salmond's theory of law of torts. Now coming to the supporters of Winfield's theory of law of tort. The profound supporters of this theory supports the theory by stating the principle of ubi jus ibi remedium, which means that when there is a wrong caused to the plaintiff, there is a remedy with the plaintiff to compensate him for the damages incurred. In other words, there always arises a cause of action in tort law that whenever a person knowingly or deliberately hurts another person without any cause. Further, people also articulated their point of view by stating that common law is not a law which is restricted in attaching new rules and principles in its various new cases. Legal scholars also recognize this kind of wider interpretation as a good means to achieve the objective of society. Now coming to the supporters of Salmond's theory of law of torts. Scholars who supported this theory state that the principle of Salmond does not restrict the court's power from establishing new rules. Rather, they stated that this theory helps in the creation of new tort rules, but unless they are significant to the other torts that are already in place. Now coming to the criticism of Winfield's theory of law of torts. As we can see, there is no uniformity and pre-decided wrongs, and because of its ever-evolving jurisprudence, which allows new wrongs to be included in it, can turn out to be a misuse of this theory. Now coming to the criticism of Salmond's theory of law of torts. As we can see, there was a limited scope in categorizing wrongs of tortious liability because there are certain wrongs which cannot fit into the narrow boxes of pigeonhole sections of wrong. Hey everyone, if you find this video useful, do like, share and comment. We'll meet with the next video very soon. Till then, bye-bye. Thank you.